Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum dears. We will be discussing today the plot summary of the play The Three Penny Opera, written by Bertolt Brecht. Let's discuss the summary. The play opens in the bigger shop, which is owned by Peachum, one of the major characters in the play. Peachum has taken control of all the biggers in London and runs a shop that outfits the biggers and provides them with a location to big in. A young man comes in and asks for a job. Peachum makes the man pay him first, and then he shows the man 5 different areas in London where he can beg. Actually, Peachum is a person who provides license for begging. After this scene, we meet with another character, the wife of Peachum, Mrs. Peachum. When she arrives, Peachum asks her about his daughter Polly. She tells him that Polly has been seeing a gentleman lately, and when she describes the man, Peachum realizes that it is none other than Macheath the Knife, who is the most powerful criminal in London. He runs upstairs and sees that Polly did not come home that night. Meanwhile, Polly and Macheath have just broken into a stable where they are getting married. The rest of the gang members arrive and they attend the wedding party. They present different presents that had been stolen by them. Soon one of the gang members shouts that police are coming, but Macheath did not bother about this news. And then Tiger Brown, the sheriff, arrives. But instead of arresting them, all he greets Macheath as an old friend. Macheath explains that he and Brown served together in the war and that he has paid Brown kickbacks on every job ever since. After Brown leaves, the men present Polly and Macheath a large bed to sleep in, and then they leave them alone. When Polly returns home, she finds her parents furious with her for marrying Macheath. She tries to defend the marriage, but they decide to take on Macheath and destroy him. Mr. Peachum tells his wife that he will go to the Tiger Brown and make him arrest Macheath. Meanwhile, Mrs. Peachum agrees to go and bribe the whore, Jenny, whom Macheath goes to every week. She is hoping that the whore will turn in Macheath. Polly goes with her father and watches as Brown agrees to arrest Macheath. She then goes back to the stable where Macheath is staying and tries to warn him. He does not believe her in the start, but later on he realizes the point. He hands over the business to Polly and tells her what to do. Macheath informs the gang members that from now onward Polly is the leader and they all should obey her. Meanwhile, Mrs. Peachum approaches Jenny, a prostitute, and convinces her to turn in Macheath. Jenny tells Mrs. Peachum that Macheath will come to brothel and only then the police will be able to arrest him. The evening in the brothel, one of Macheath's men is trying to convince the whores that Macheath would not be so foolish to show up. However, no sooner does he say this, Macheath arrives and sits down. Jenny takes Mac's palm and reads it, warning him that a woman will betray him. He thinks she means Polly. Jenny soon sneaks out while Macheath is talking with other hordes. Constable Smith enters and tries to arrest Macheath, who knocks the man down and jumps out the window. Unfortunately for him, Mrs. Peachum is staying there with other police officers. They take him away. Jenny wakes up Macheath's man, who has fallen asleep while reading and missed the entire scene. Now in prison, Macheath is afraid that Tiger Brown will learn that he has been playing around with Brown's daughter Lucy, another female who is in a relationship with Macheath. She soon arrives and is horrified to see him in jail. To complicate matters further, Polly arrives and also claims Macheath as her husband. Both women argue. Lucy indicates that she is pregnant and therefore she has a better claim to Macheath. But Polly is legally married to him and she has paper to prove it. Macheath chooses to support Lucy instead of Polly because he is more afraid of Tiger Brown. Mrs. Peachum then arrives and drags Polly away. Lucy, happy to finally be alone with Macbeth again, hands him his hat and can and leaves. When Constable Smith returns, he tries to get the can, but Macbeth is faster than he is and manages to escape. Brown enters the cell and is relieved to see that it is empty. However, Peachum also arrives and threatens to disrupt the coronation of the Queen if Brown does not find Macbeth and arrest him again immediately. The night, Peachum outfits his beggars with signs and clothes in an effort to ruin the coronation of the Queen parade the next morning. The whores arrived, led by Jenny, and ask for their reward for turning in Macbeth. Peachum refuses to pay them on the grounds that Macbeth escaped already. Jenny, in a fit of rage, tells them that Macbeth is far better man than any of them. She then accidentally reveals that Macbeth had gone straight to her place and that he is now with another whore named Tawdry. Peachum becomes happy by this information and promises to give the whores the reward money. He sends one of his beggars to get the police. Tiger Brown arrives only a few minutes later. Brown has decided that rather than arresting Macbeth, it would be better to arrest Peachum and all the other beggars. Peachum merely ignores Brown's threat and points out that there are far more beggars than there are police. Unable to arrest Peachum, Brown realizes that he is caught in a bind. Peachum then demands that Brown arrests Macbeth and gives him the address where Macbeth is staying. Polly goes to visit Lucy in an effort to find out where Macbeth is. It turns out that neither of them knows where Macbeth is, causing Polly to laugh and state that Macbeth has stood them both up. They soon hear a noise in the hallway and realize that Macbeth has been arrested. The next morning, the same day the coronation procession is set for, Macbeth is brought out of his cell and locked into the public cell. He is going to be hanged at 6 in the morning and has only an hour to live. He offers Smith £1,000 in cash if Smith will let him escape, but Smith refuses to make any promise. Jake and Matthews, the other two gang members, arrive and Macbeth asks them for money. They say that it will be very difficult for them to arrange money, but they will try. Polly also arrives and tells Macbeth that his business is going well, but she has no money this time to pay. Brown finally enters the cell as well, and he and Macbeth settle their accounts. Having failed to get the money, Smith refuses to help Macbeth. Soon thereafter, all the characters return and stand next to the cage. Jake and Matthew apologize for not getting the money in time and tell Macbeth that all the other crooks are stealing elsewhere. Even the whore have showed up to watch him die. Macbeth gives a last speech in which he claims all the small crooks are being pushed aside by corporate interests. Peachum then stands up and gives the final speech, arguing that since this is opera and not real life, they will save Macbeth. Brown enters as a messenger and brings a special order from the Queen. She has decided to pardon Macbeth and to also elevate him to a hereditary knighthood. Macbeth rejoices his good luck while Peachum remarks that such a thing would never happen in real life. In real life, there is no happy ending like this. This was all the summary of the play. Thank you for watching.